nervous system, we have seen the introduction of the nervous system and the characteristics of the nervous system and the classification of nervous system, and we have seen the structure of neuron. So now we are discussing about the structure of neuron and its parts. So we have seen the structure of neuron, that are the contains which type of parts and each part what it contains and how it is present in the parts in the neuron. So that thing we have seen. So now I am going to explain about the, that is this myelin sheath also part of the neuron, and how it is working and what is the use of this myelin sheath. So that thing now we will see. So myelin sheath. So already we have seen in three terms what myelin sheath. So myelin sheath, myelin is an insulating layer that forms around nerves, including those in the brain. So this myelin sheath is an insulating layer and that form around nerve. So this myelin sheath is forming around the nerve, including those in the brain and spinal cord. So this myelin sheath is the insulating layer that forms the around nerve, and not only the nerve, next thing is including those in the brain and spinal cord. And next one is, it is made up of protein and fatty substance. So this myelin sheath is made up of protein and fatty substances. So this myelin sheath is the formation of, it is one type of layer, and it is formed around the nerve and not only the nerve, and it is including the brain and spinal cord. And this myelin sheath is made up of protein and fatty substances. The next thing is, the process of myelin sheath is to, this process of myelin sheath is to, what is the purpose of this myelin sheath in the neuron? So to allow impulses to transmit quickly and efficiently along the nerve cells. So the purpose of myelin sheath means, the purpose of myelin sheath, that is to allow impulses to transmit quickly and efficiently along with the nerve cells. So this is the purpose of myelin sheath. So we have seen, that is, the myelin sheath is insulating the layer and it is forming by nerve cells formed around nerves and including the brain and spinal cord. And next thing is, this myelin sheath is made up of protein and fatty substances. And next thing is, the purpose of this myelin sheath, it is allow impulses to transmit quickly and efficiently along with the nerve cells. So this is the purpose of myelin sheath. And next thing is, if myelin sheath is damaged, so if the myelin sheath is damaged, what will happen if the myelin sheath is damaged? Actually, the purpose of myelin sheath, that is the, what it is carrying, that is the impulses and to transmit quickly. So when it is damaged, there is automatically impulses are slowed down. So due to damage of this myelin sheath, there is a chance to get impulses slowed down. So not only the slow down, and it can cause the such as multiple sclerosis disease also. So this is the function of the myelin sheath. So myelin sheath is nothing but, it is an insulating layer and it is formed around the nerve and including the brain and spinal cord also. And next thing is, this myelin sheath is made up of protein and fatty substances. And the purpose of myelin sheath, that is the, it is allowing and allow impulses and to transmit quickly and efficiently along with the nerve cells. If this myelin sheath is damaged, so what will happen? There is a chance to get slowdown of impulses. And not only the slowdown, it can cause such as multiple sclerosis disease. lot of the neuron, myelin sheath. And next thing is nodes of Ranvier. So nodes of Ranvier. So this part we have seen the neuron diagram. So what it is working? Or what is the function of this nodes of Ranvier? So these are also called myelin sheath gaps. So these nodes of Ranvier called as the where it is where they can call it as the Ranvier. So where the myelin sheath is present in between the gap. So that is known as nodes of Ranvier. Ranvier. And these are also called myelin sheath gaps. These are the gaps approximately 1 micrometer in length. So the between the myelin sheath and next thing is the nodes of Ranvier. In between these the length is 1 micrometer, approximately 1 micrometer in length. Next thing is formed between the myelin sheath and generated by different cells. So it is forming between the myelin sheath and it is generating the different cells. So it is forming in between the myelin sheath and it is generating the different cells. And it knows of Ranvier, the around membrane is uninsulated and therefore capable of generating electrical activity. So this nodes of Ranvier, it is the axonal membrane is uninsulated. So whereas seen here, myelin is insulating, whereas comfort this nodes of Ranvier, it is uninsulated and therefore capable of generating electrical activity. So this is the nodes of Ranvier. And next thing is equilateral axon. Next one is equilateral axon. So it is also part of the neuron. And what is the function of this equilateral axon? We see. So is a branch and separated from the main axon. So it is also branched and it is separated from the axon, and that generally after separating from the axon, what it is working generally feeds back on the sonar to the sonar. So this is the cell body of the neuron. The soma is the cell body of the neuron, soma, and it is a branch and it is separated from the axon and it is generally feeds back onto the soma. And next thing is this occurs to facilitate the modulation of cell firing. So after separated from the axon, next it is generally feeds back onto the soma. And next thing, this occurs to facilitate the modulation of cell firing. So what it is facilitating? The modulation of cell firing. And next thing is the process of separation from the main axon is also known as axon collateral. So here by name itself we can understand that is the it is separated from the axon. So this process of separation from the main axon is also known as axon collateral. So this is the function of equilateral axon. So it is nothing but this axon collateral is the branch of axon and it is separated from the axon. And next thing is, after separated from the axon, it is generally feeds back onto the soma, and soma is the cell body of the neuron. Next thing is, this occurs to facilitate the motor. sulfiding. And next thing is the process of this separation from the main axon is also known as axon collateral. So this is the part of the neuron. Next we will see axon terminals. So what is the function of axon terminals? We will see. So this axon terminal also is the part of the neuron. So in the structure of neuron we have seen that is the axon terminals is present. So what is the function of this axon terminals? So it is also called as a synaptic buttons. So this axon terminals also called as the synaptic buttons. And next thing is, what is the function of these axon terminals? Are distal or termination of the branches and axon. So it is the distal or termination of the branches of axon, and axon of fiber is a long. It is the distal termination, it is the distal termination of the branch of an axon. So axon terminal is the distal termination of the branches of an axon. And next thing is, an axon nerve fiber is a long. So this nerve fiber is a long. And next thing is, the slender projection of nerve cell or neuron that conductivity. So the slender projection of a nerve cell or neuron that conducts electrical impulses. So the slender projection of a nerve cell or neuron that conducts electrical impulses made in the axon terminals. So by name itself we can understand that is the axon terminal is the distal termination of branch of the axon. And next thing is, an axon nerve fiber is a long and slender projection of a nerve cell or neuron that conducts electrical impulses. And next thing is, it is called as an action potentials. So this slender projection of a nerve cell or neuron that conducts electrical impulses. So that is called as a action potentials. And next thing is, it is away from the neuron's cell body or stoma. So this thing is away from the neurons or cell body or stoma in order to transmit those impulses to other neurons. So why it is? So after seeing this slender projection of a nerve cell or neuron that conducts the electrical impulses, and it is called as action potentials. So after that, it is away from the neurons. So it is away from the neurons, cell body, as stoma. Why? In order to transmit those impulses to the other nerves. So that is the purpose of axon terminals. So by name itself we can understand that is the axon terminals also called as the synaptic buttons, and it is the distal termination of the branches of an axon. And next thing is, this axon nerve fiber is a long, and the slender projection of a nerve cell or neuron that conducts electrical impulses, and it is called as the action potential. And it is away from the neuron's cell body or stoma. Why it is away from the neurons or cell body or stoma? For what purpose? In order to transmit those impulses to other neurons. So this is the function of axon terminals. This is the part of the neuron. And next thing is dendrites. So next thing is dendrites. So we'll see what is the function of dendrites. These are many short processes that receive and carry incoming impulses. impulses towards cell body. So here by name itself we can understand that is the very short process. So the dendrites is the very short process and that receives and carry incoming impulses. To where it is carrying the incoming impulses? Towards cell bodies. Towards cell bodies it is carrying the incoming impulses. And it is very short process and it is carrying incoming impulses towards cell bodies. And next thing is they have the same structure as axon but are usually shorter and branching. So these dendrites also have the same structure as the axon but here usually shorter and branching. So they have the same structure as the axon but are usually shorter and branching. And next thing is large axons are covered by a myelin sheath. So these large axons are covered by a myelin sheath and are termed as a myelinated fibers. So these large axons are covering by myelin sheath and then are termed as a myelinated fibers. So this is the dendrite's function. So these dendrites are also part of the neuron and these dendrites are nothing but it is a very short process and it is receiving and incoming. It is received and carry incoming impulses. Where it is carrying and receiving that impulses towards cell bodies and they have the same structure as the axon but are usually shorter and branching. It has the same structure as the axon but it is usually short or branching. And next thing is large axons are covered by myelin sheath and the term as a myelinated fibers. After covering this large axon with myelin sheath, that term, what is term? So myelinated fibers. So this is the main function of dendrites. So now we have completed the part of this neuron. So parts of the neuron. So we have seen the structure of neuron and how many parts it consists and each part what it is function. So that thing now we have seen. So first we have seen that is the nerve cell body. So in nerve cell body, what it is there and what it contains and how it is working in the human body. And next thing is we have seen the axon. So how this axon and what it is extension and what from where that cell body is extension, the thing we have seen. And next thing is node of Ranvier. So that thing also we have seen. And next one is myelin sheath. So what is the purpose of myelin sheath? If it is damaged in the nervous system, what will happen and which type of disease the patient can get by damaging of this myelin sheath? That thing we came to know. And next thing is a collateral axon. So how this collateral axon can call? So how they are going to call this collateral axon? So by separation, which parts it is separating in this collateral axon? So that thing we have seen. And next one is axon terminals we have seen. So what it is function of the neuron? And next thing is dendrites also we have seen. So now we have completed the nervous system. Structure of neuron. So we have seen the introduction of nervous system and by introduction only we came to know that it is the chief controlling and coordinating whether it is voluntary or involuntary. And next thing is classification of nervous system. In the classification it has divided in two parts, that is central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. So what the central nervous system it is consisting and the peripheral nervous system what it is consisting and each one what is the function of those systems we came to know. And next thing is we have seen that is the characteristics of neuron. So in characteristics, by name itself we came to know that is the difference between the irritability and conductivity. Whereas come for irritability, it is initiate now impulse to the so initiating the impulse in response to stimuli. And whereas come for conductivity, it is also ability to transmit the impulse outside of the body. That is the difference between the conductivity and irritability. And next we have seen the structure of neuron. This neuron, how many parts it contains, and each part, what is the function of that, we have seen. So completed this topic. Thank you.